In this video, we'll be using the Garmin Explore mobile app to create waypoints and courses, and we'll get them to transfer wirelessly to our Montana 700 right here. So let's flip over to our smartphone and continue from there. So before we get started, make sure you have the Garmin Explore mobile app installed on your smartphone, and then have your smartphone paired via Bluetooth to your Garmin Montana 700 device, and we'll get started here. So we're going to open up the Garmin Explore app, and what we're going to do here, we're planning for a trip to do some ATV riding or other outdoor activities. So we're going to do a little bit of planning. So we're going to create a waypoint and a course. So we're going to create an unloading point and then a track that we can follow. So as you can see here, we scrolled over to a new area of the map, and the app automatically is downloading the topo active for that area. So if you are connected on Wi-Fi, that will go pretty fast. So let's zoom into our area. And what we're going to do here, we're going to start by adding a waypoint. This is going to be an unloading point or a parking spot we're going to do. So what we're going to do here is we're going to check our map settings first, because we want to make sure that we have our collections set up. So Garmin Explore uses the concept of collections, which is kind of like a filter. So I've been using Garmin Explore for a few years, so I have quite a few collections, but usually I keep a collection for each GPS device that I have. So you can see here I have the Map 66, Tread, and Montana. So I turned everything off and make sure that I'm turning on Montana, because the content that I'm going to create on the app, I want it to go to the Montana. And this is the collection I have set up on the device itself to sync with. So with that, there's some other map settings here you may interest you, such as downloading maps via Wi-Fi only or cellular. But now that we have our collections set up, now we can start adding a waypoint. And what I'm going to do here is I'm just going to tap on the screen to create the waypoint. And now we have a couple options. We can actually navigate. We can see the coordinates, but we also have the option to create the waypoint. So we're going to tap on that, and we have this pop-up. So it will add this waypoint to our collection, right? Which is the Montana, which since we're paired with the Montana 700, it wants to sync it to that default collection. So now it should be wirelessly transferred over to the Montana, but we can still edit this waypoint. We're going to choose a different marker. So this is actually a parking spot. So we're going to find the parking icon. And what we can also do is maybe rename this waypoint. So I'm going to tap on the three dots at the top right, and I'm going to rename. I'm going to tap on that, and I'm just going to give it a new name. Once that's done, tap OK. And now the updates I've done should be transferred over to the Montana 700. So with that, now let's see. Let's go back and tap on done. So now what we're going to do now is we're going to follow this dotted line, which is a converted rails to trail, which is now an ATV trail. So what we're going to do is tap on the plus icon on the top left, and we're going to create a course. Now we're in our course editor. So what we're going to do here, we're going to zoom in a bit, and I'm going to tap anywhere on the screen. It creates a little point, but that's not where I want to do it. Bottom left, I have the undo. Tap on that, remove the point. I'm going to tap on the actual waypoint that I just created. You may not see it highlighted, but it is highlighted. And then I'm going to tap elsewhere on the screen, and you can see that it created a path from the waypoint to my new point, and it snapped it on the trail. That's because on the bottom right, we have the magnet icon. So let me add another point. You can see it does a straight line. So I want my path to be snapped to the trail. So I'm going to make sure that the magnet is turned on. And now I'm just going to start adding my point. So tap to add a point, pinch to move things around, and then you start adding. I can tap on the magnifying glass on the top right, and I can look up any other waypoints or stuff from my library. But from here, I'm just going to zoom out a little bit, and I'm just going to continue to add courses. You can also toggle between map layers by tapping on the map icon on the top left. Here I only had topo active, but you may have bird's eye and some other maps that Garmin Explore offers for the region you're in. So I'm just gonna keep on tapping the map here to snap the trail, making sure that it's not going on different trails, and this is indeed the trail. You can see from the shading here, we're gonna go in the kind of in the valley, but we're going to end up right here. That's as far as we're gonna go. You can see the distance at the top, 21.8, 12 points. So with that, we can tap on the question mark. They'll give us all the functions in our course editor if we forget how to do certain things. But with the course created, it wants to sync it to the collection. We're going to say yes. And now that we have our course created, I can now rename the course. So I'm going to tap on the title here and I'm just going to rename it just like when I did the waypoints. I can also tap on the points to review the points that the course created. And I can also check out the elevation profile. Looks like we're gonna go uphill on this trip. I can tap on the three dots on the type right to review all the actions here. And now that I have the course kind of set up here, I can now go back to our map page and tap on the library tab at the bottom. And I'm going to scroll down to my collection, which is Montana. And I can see everything that's in my collection. You can see this is the tracks. I'm going to tap on the courses and you can see that I have the course created right there. And we can see it, all the details. So now we should be ready to flip over to our Montana and see what happened.
So now that we created the waypoint and the course on our Garmin Explore mobile app, we can now see if it's loaded properly on our Montana. So what I'm gonna do here, let's check on the waypoint first. So we're gonna go under the waypoint manager and we can see here that we have our waypoint that we created. I can tap on it and view on the map. There it is right there. But I don't seem to see the course here. And in fact, if I were to go back, go to my route planner, I don't see my route. And let me go under tracks. I don't see my track. So where did it go? So the problem here, if you remember, when we were creating our course, we had some options to convert as a track and convert as a route. So we're gonna go back to our Explore mobile app and finish the job.
And we're back in our Garmin Explore mobile app and we're gonna go back to our course. And we're going to now tap on our three dots at the top right. And we're going to do a couple things before we start copying to the route and the track. One, I'm going to change the color of our course to red. And once that's done, let's tap it again. And now we're going to copy this as a route. And we get this dialog to indicate that it's going to get added to our collection. And then that will get synced to our device. And here's our new route dialog. You see in the top middle where it says new route. So now that we know that got created, I can go and verify this in my library. Go under the root section here and you can see that it just got created. There it is. So now we're gonna go back to our course and we're gonna tap on the three dots again at the top right and we're going to copy as a track. We get the same dialog and we have the new track pop up. And now that that should be created, we can go back now to our library and we can see in our track that got added to that section of the library. So with that, we should be good to go and let's go back to our device.
All right, so now what we did here, we took our course in our Garmin Explore mobile app and then we converted it to a track and a route and it transferred wirelessly to our Montana device. So let's just double check what it looks like here. We're gonna go under Route Planner and we can see that the route is there. And you can see it has the points. You can see the details on the map. Looks fairly okay. You can take a look at the elevation profile. Looks fine. Let's go back. And we're going to go under Save Tracks. Again, our track is there. We can tap on it. And you can see the distance. Again, we can take a look on the map. That looks a little bit better. And you have the elevation profile here. And there you go. So basically you can use either or to when you're on site, when you unload with your ATV or side-by-side or any off-road vehicle, you can follow either the route or the track. Or if you're displayed on the map, then you can follow it along on the display. And there you go. That is how you can create a course in Waypoints using the Garmin Explore mobile app and transfer it to your Garmin Montana 700 series device.